pray for preaching power. But I ask right now in the name of Jesus that you move me out of the way. Let your humble servant step forward. Lord, I pray that I may decrease and that you may increase in me. Lord God, give me what to say, when to say it, and how to say it unto your people. Hide me, O God, behind thine old cross. And I'll be careful to give your name the honor. Give you the praise and all the glory is yours. It is in the precious name of Jesus the Christ of Nazareth that I pray. And the people of God said, amen. Come on, put your hands together. Jesus the Christ and to the Holy Spirit. To all of you, my brothers and sisters in Christ, it is just good to be in the house of God one more time. Certainly to my friend Pastor Lattimore, to the members of Tabernacle Missionary Baptist Church of Dearborn, Arkansas. God bless you. Come on, give them a hand, please. First Missionary Baptist Church of Ayan, Oklahoma. God bless you. There is a word today, and we do not purpose to keep too long. As I told you last week, we're going to continue with the message in which we started last week out of the book of Luke chapter 5. Luke chapter 5, and we will be in the 5th verse today. Luke chapter 5 and verse number 5. Amen. When you find it, say amen. Amen. If you're still looking, say hold up, preacher. Amen. Y'all quiet on me today. Amen. But it's all right. We're going to praise God anyhow. Amen. Amen. Luke chapter 5 and verse 5. If you're down, say amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Luke chapter 5 and verse 5 says, and Simon answering said unto him, Master, we have toiled all the night and have taken nothing. Nevertheless, at thy word, I will let down the net. May the Lord add a blessing to the readers, ears, and doers of his word, and may we all be strengthened there.
Yes,
Lord. Amen.
Preach the word. Preach the word.
And just for a thought, for a few minutes this morning, my brothers and my sisters, want to talk with this thought in mind. Look at your neighbor. Say, neighbor.
Neighbor.
Oh, neighbor.
You got to move.
At his word. Look at your other neighbor. Say, neighbor.
Neighbor.
Oh, neighbor. I don't care what nobody else do.
I'm moving
at his word. If you believe it, give God some praise.
Amen.
Amen. That's what we want to talk to. Again, this is part two of our message concluding at his word. Last week we dealt with the thought that we got to go deeper, which is in verse 4. It says, launch out into the deep and let down your net. But on this week, we're going to conclude in verse 5 with at his word. My brothers and my sisters, a few years ago, you could do business with a man or a woman on a handshake and their word. Can I get a witness? I mean, if a man told you he would do something, you could count on it, or you could take it to the bank. You see, a man's word was and still should be his bond. Your word ought to mean something when you tell somebody something. Back then, you didn't need a contract. You didn't have to go get it notarized. You didn't even have to have a witness to what was going on. All you needed was a man's word. And I remember as a kid, I would hear my mother say, "Whatever you do, boy, don't mess up your name." I wish I had some country folk up in here. You see, back when you didn't have credit lines, I wish I had a witness. Before they got a credit report and before banks would loan any of us anybody, y'all are helping me, all we had was our word. And if your word was good, then you was good. But if your word wasn't no good, can I get a witness? Then you wasn't in it. Good. Then you wasn't any good. But nowadays, folk would give you their word and make any excuse for not doing what they said they would do. They will give you their word, and before they can finish giving you their word, they already make an excuse for why they can't do it. Somebody said, "Preach up in there, preacher." In other words, they say they would say, "Well, I will do it if it's the Lord's will and the creek don't rise." But I come by to serve notice today that if it's the Lord's will, the creek can rise, but I serve a God who's got a boat. I wish I had somebody. I don't care how high the flood waters come. I don't care how high the mountain is. The God that I serve is able to make a way out of nowhere. I come by to serve notice that I don't care what nobody else do in the church. I got to move at the word of God. I don't care if don't nobody else go. Matter of fact, one songwriter said, "I'll go if I got to go all by myself." That's why we gotta quit. I feel like preaching a little while now. That's why we gotta quit coming to church looking for everything else except for a word from God. Because if you just get a word from the Lord, anything else you need, if you need healing, get a word from God. If you need delivering, get a word from God. If you need some peace, then get a word from the Lord. Excuses to God, but God will make a way for you to do whatever it is that he needs you to do, because his will must be done. You or I cannot change it or rearrange it. I used to say that if God said it, I believe it, and that settled it, but now if God said it, it's already settled, because he's not a man that he can lie. If he said it, he'll do it. If he's speaking, it shall come. Somebody shout that his word, that is word. John 1:1 says, "In the beginning was the word, and the word was with God, and the word was God." John 1:14 says, "And the word was made flesh and dwelt among us." I told the pastor I was intending on teaching this today, but I found out that it was going to be a preacher in the house this morning. So I said, "God, we got to preach this thing, because he don't want to hear me talk. He want to hear a word." It says, "After his word, my brother and sister, I need you to know that Jesus Christ is the word of God in the flesh. In the beginning, before there was a when or a why, there was Jesus. Before there was a here or there, there was Jesus." In the beginning, when everything first got started, God was right there, and Jesus was right there with him. Jesus, he was the word, the logos, the spoken word of God. Jesus is what came out of the mouth of God when he spoke. And my question today is, what's coming out of your mouth? I feel like what's coming out of your mouth when you speak to folks? What do folks hear when you say that I love the Lord? I wish I had a witness. What do folks hear when they say he heard my cry? Listen, what are they hearing when you speak? He is the spoken word, the logos, the spoken word. It's what came out of the mouth of God. It said, "In the beginning was the word, and the word was with God." See, a lot of folk can lay in your bed. I wish I had somebody up in here. Be in your house, eat your food, and still not be with you. Get this in a minute. See, we got a lot of folks that's riding in your car, drinking up your drink. Can I preach a little while? Smoking up your smoke and still ain't with you. They spending your money doing all of this, but they ain't with you. They just down in your presence.
That's true.
Oh, Lord, help me up this other day. God, he said, "In the beginning was the word, and the word was with God, and the word was God." But I want you to know today, my brother and sister, he not only was God then, he's still God right now. For I hear him telling his disciples, if you have seen me, you have seen the Father. I and the Father are one. He thought it not robbery to be equal with God. Then he wrapped himself. Oh, that's going to make me preach hard today. Wrapped himself up in some flesh and came down to 42 generations. He is the word of God in the flesh. Genesis 1, Genesis, let me find it real quick. I don't want y'all to think I'm telling y'all a story. In Genesis chapter 1 and verse 3, it says, and God said, in other words, he spoke the word. In Genesis 1 and 3, it says, and God said, let thou be light. Then he skipped on down a little bit farther. It goes down and says, not only was let that be light. In Genesis 1 and 6, it said, let that be ferments. In Genesis 1 and 9, it said, let the waters be gathered together. In other words, God spoke a word, and whatever he spoke, it had to come to pass. As a matter of fact, at his word, somebody say, at his word real quick. At his word, dog came barking. Can I get a witness? At his word, rabbits came hopping. At his word, trees came up out of nowhere. At his word, deals came running, and rabbits came hopping. At his word, he made peaches sweet and lemon sour with the peppers hot. At the word of God, he spoke the word. Everything he spoke, it had to come. As you look at the text, and I told you I'm going to preach long today because I don't want to wait. As we look at the text last week, the disciples here in Luke have been out on a fishing expedition. They have been out fishing all the night long, and the Bible says that they hadn't caught nothing. And in verse 2 or verse 1 of chapter 5, it says that they had been out fishing, and they were now back at land. It was morning time, and they were washing their nets. In other words, they had been out, hadn't caught nothing. Now they're back in the daytime, in the morning time, washing their nets. They didn't catch nothing, say they died. They said, we didn't catch nothing, so we going back home. And many times on this Christian journey, you and I will go out witnessing, go on our ministry, and sometimes we ain't going to catch nothing. But I come to tell you that even though you ain't caught nothing, you still need to wash your nets. Even though you ain't caught nothing, you still need to mend your nets back together. It is a theological fact that the fishermen would fish at nighttime because the fish would see the net during the daytime and swim around it. And so we got some folk that we can't jump to them dressed up like preachers. We can't come to them dressed up like saints. We can't come to them looking like church folk. We got to disguise our nets while they say nothing in order to catch somebody. These were professional fishermen. They knew how to fish. They knew where the fish bit at. They knew how to bait their hooks. But yet and still, they caught nothing. They were washing their nets. And in verse 4 from last week, Jesus tell them, you're going to have to launch out into the deep. And I come by to tell the church today, if we're going to catch a drop for a new building, I wish I had somebody there. If we're going to catch a drop while we're running and overflowing, we're going to have to go deeper than we ever been in our life. Our prayer life has got to go deeper. Our worship has got to be deeper. And our devotion to God has got to be deeper. So in our text, chapter 5, in our text, chapter 5, verse 5, it says, And when Simon answered him and said, Master, we have toiled all the night and have taken nothing. Nevertheless, at thy word, I will let down the net. Here, my brothers and sisters, Jesus had just told them to launch into the deep. And Simon Peter, y'all know who Simon is, don't y'all? You know Peter, he was the cussing disciple. Peter was the knife-packing, knife-toting, ear-cutting-off disciple. Peter was the one that had the revelation that said, upon this rock I'll build my church, and the gates of hell shall not prevail. He said, thou art the Christ, the Son of the living God. Peter was the petrol, a small piece of the rock. Peter was somebody in the kingdom of God. Peter said whatever was on his mind. I always say Peter was more like us than anybody else in the Bible. Because Peter said, I'm a disciple, but God's still working. I wish I had somebody. You know, every now and then my flesh will rile up. Every now and then I might cuss. I wasn't going to say nothing. Don't make me come down your row. Every now and then I might cuss a little bit. Every now and then I might try to fight a little bit. Every now and then I might go somewhere. God's going to help me up in there today. Peter was more like us than anybody else. So Peter said in verse God. And Simon answered. Now, the reason Peter answered, because it was Peter's boat. That Jesus went and got on. And I come to tell you, you ought to invite Jesus on your boat every now and then. The reason we can't get what we want because we won't let Jesus in the house. Yeah. So Peter answered and said unto him, Master. And I pause right there when I say that word master, because Peter understood that if you're my master, then you tell me what to do. Am I right about it? Peter said, Master, we have talked all night. We done struggled with this thing. We done wrestled with it. We done fought with it. We done tried to do it. We done the best we can. As a matter of fact, I called the bank, and the bank said, you can't have the money. I wrestled with it. I talked with it. I called the lawyers. They said they couldn't do nothing about it. They said, we've been toiling with this thing all night long, and I want you to know, church, some problems, some storms, you're going to have to wrestle with for a little while. The Bible said, weeping may endure for a night, but joy coming in the morning. Some of these problems ain't going to go away. You're going to have to toil a little while. You're going to have to go through some stuff for a little while. You're going to have to wrestle. It's going to be hard. You may have to cry sometime. You may have to walk the floor late at night sometime. You may even have to come to the church lay prostrate right out on the altar and call on the name of the Lord. And say, we have toiled all the night. We've been fighting this thing and taking nothing. Working hard and still ain't getting nowhere. It's like putting money in pockets with holes in it. I don't know about nobody else, but sometimes it seems like every time I get a dollar, somebody need two. He said, we've toiled all the night long and have caught nothing. But then Peter, knowing that Christ is his master, he said, nevertheless. That was our word for the week, wasn't it? He said, nevertheless. In other words, in spite of what happened last night, somebody should have shouted right there, because you know you caught hell all night long last night. I mean, you ain't even slept at all last night. Your phone kept on ringing, your head kept hurting, your children kept acting a fool. You got 5 calls before 3 o'clock this morning. He said, nevertheless, what happened last night, in spite of who else don't want to go to church, in spite of how my head and my back is hurting, in spite of, nevertheless, at thy word, and I need to go on and get out of here today. He said, at thy word, I will let down my net. And I come by to tell somebody here today, on my way to heaven, I might as well go on and close now, that we got to move at the word of Jesus. Every now and then, you ought to shout at his word. For the Bible then said, make a joyful noise unto the Lord. Every now and then, you ought to give God praise at his word. For it said, everything that has breath, can I get a witness in here? Praise the Lord. Every now and then, you ought to dance at the word of God. It said, you ought to have a holy dance in you. After all that the Lord has done for us, we ought to be able to give him praise just on his word. You ought not have to get it in your hand. You ought not have to put your hand on it, because we walk by faith. Oh, Lord, help me up in here. And not by sight. It said, at his word, I'm going to give him praise. At his word, I'm going to worship him, give him honor and glory. At his word, I'm going to let down my net, and I don't care what kind of fish. And that's what we got to get out of, trying to pick what kind of fish we want to catch. You just drop your net, and whatever God put in the net, I don't care if they're rich, poor, orange, black, or green. Whatever God has put in your net, we done got so sophisticated, we done got so smart, we done got so educated now. We don't just want to catch the fish, we want to clean them.
I think I'll let that
sit
in for a minute.
We done got so educated now, we think we can do God's job. We just don't want to catch them, but God told us, you just catch them, and I'll take care of them when you bring them back to the bank. A friend of mine told me, he said, you know why God told him to catch them and bring them back? See, a lifeguard don't dive in the water and save you. He dives in there to bring you out. We need to be dragging some fish out of the swamp of Bahia. We ought to be dragging some fish out of the city of Bahia and out of all these little cracks and crevices. And I don't know about nobody else, but I'm glad today, my brothers and sisters, that I serve a God who's able to look beyond all of my faults and still meet my every need. At his word, we got to let down our nets. At Why? Because some 2,000 years ago, out on a hill called Calvary, I got on heaven today. I see my Lord and I see our Savior. I see my big brother and I see my Redeemer. I see Jesus as God is walking around heaven. He's looking for somebody that will go on his word. He looked at Abraham and Abraham just couldn't do it. Looked at Isaac and Jacob and neither one of them can do it. Looked down through the ages of time and he saw Matthew, Luke, Mark, Luke, and John. But neither one of them do it. Looked on down in Durham, Arkansas, out of the little community called Halley, Arkansas. Saw a little black bald-headed boy with a mama named Mary. Said, well, he gonna be all right, but he ain't gonna be able to do it neither. Then I see my Lord. I see Jesus. He said, if the Lord needs somebody, here am I. Send me, Lord. So God has sent the Lord in your spirit. I see Jesus as he looked down and he saw that man was in a terrible shape. And I see Jesus say, at your word, I'll wrap myself in some flesh. At thy word, I'll be born to a virgin called Mary. At your word, I will walk the dusty streets of Jerusalem. And at thy word, I'll never march me from judgment hall to judgment hall. And the Bible says that they hung him high. Stretched him wide. He died until the sun refused to shine. He died until the moon dripped down in blood. But early, I said early, early on Sunday morning, he got up. He got up. Is there anybody here that know he got up? Shout yes. Ain't too mean, ain't too bad to give God some praise. Shout yes, shout yes. I don't know how you feel about it, but he walks with me, he talks with me, and he tells me I am his own. I'm the joy, I said the joy that we share. Listen, we can't move until we get a word.
That's right.
From the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Don't let nobody push you into doing something that God ain't told you to do. Folks will walk up to you in a minute and tell you that the Lord told me to tell you that you need to do this. And I tell them, well, when the Lord tell me and I get a word, then I move. Because I'm not going to move until I get a word from the Lord. Here Simon Peter said, nevertheless, in spite of who else died with counsel. In spite of us, who else didn't graduate from college? He said, nevertheless, at thy word.
Yes.
I ain't got to have no proof.
Yes.
I ain't got to see nothing.
Yes.
There ain't got to be no evidence that you're going to do it. Just give me the word.
Yes,
tell me that you're going to do it.
Yes.
He said, I'll let my net down.
Yes, Lord.
And I come to tell you today that you need to get a word from God.
Yes.
And when he tells you to move, whatever he say do, you need to do. One writer put it this way. He told him to cast your net on the right side. I thought about it. I said, is he talking about the right hand side or the right side? Because some of us are casting nets in wrong places. We catch it. Everything else.
Yes,
except for what God would have for us to have.
Yes,
let down your net for a drop.
Yes,
Simon Peter said, Nevertheless, at his word,
yes.
I will let down.
Yes, yes, Lord. Help us, Jesus.
We're going to go deeper.
Yes, Lord.
This is serious. This is our serious, Pastor.
Yes, Lord.
We're going to get deeper in the Lord. We're going to have a deeper relationship.
Thank you, Lord.
Yes, come
listen,
on.
What you had last year ain't going to be good enough
come on now.
To get you through this year.
Yes.
You're going to have to go deeper than you ever been.
Yes.
We're facing problems now that we have never seen before.
That's right, Lord.
Every other week, some child is being killed by another child in somebody's school.
Yes.
Every other week, there's a new disease coming out. We're seeing some. We're going to have to get deeper than we ever been before. Listen, grandmama's religion ain't good enough for 2014.
Come on now.
I know that's going to mess up a lot of folks. What that grandmama over? Ain't going to be good enough to get you there. We got way more stuff to deal with. Grandma didn't have to worry about Facebook. Grandmama didn't have to worry about Twitter. Grandmama didn't have to worry about Instagram and all this other stuff. Grandmama didn't have to worry about Ebola.
We're
going to have to get deeper in this word than we ever have been before. Our commitment has got to be deeper. Our devotion to God has got to be deeper. Our worship and our praise has got to be deeper than we ever have
before. We're not going to get
it. I know last year you shouted. But maybe this year you need to shout and dance.
Come on,
I know last year you clapped your hands. But maybe this year you need to sing and clap your hands at the same time. Matter of fact, Jesus told him this time only goes forth by fasting and praying. Do more than what we did.
Yes, Lord.
Because we're facing a different demon than we ever faced before.
Yes.
The doors of the church are open.
Yes, sir.
If you're here today and you don't know the Lord Jesus Christ as the pardon of your sins, then you ought to come right now.